First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh,
welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, welcome to my channel. Today is going to be Grayson's 5 month update. Now I'm doing this a few days before he turns 5 months, but legit, he turns 5 months the day after I'm making this video, so yeah. So basically in this video I'm just going to tell you guys all the updates on Grayson and all the updates going on with me of being postpartum for 5 months. So yeah, let's just jump right into the video. So if you are new to my channel, my name is Maya and this is my son Grayson, who is obviously almost 5 months. He's probably almost 14 pounds now, but yeah, we're gonna get into all of those facts here just in a minute. So let's start with this big boy. He is about 13 pounds, probably almost 14. He's like 20 something inches long. What else? He has light brown hair, somewhat darkish. His hair is starting to curl a little bit in the back. He so far has had brownish greenish eyes. He definitely looks like me. I can tell you guys that. He wears 6 to 9 month clothes and 3 to 6 month clothes. Some 6 to 9 month clothes fit him. Mostly 3 to 6 month clothes fit him, so he's kind of in that in-between mark where he fits in some. This outfit he's wearing is 6 to 9 months, so definitely getting there. So I guess I could do fun facts about Grayson now. Fun facts are he's sitting up with assistance. He can sit up for a few seconds on his own without anybody helping him. He loves to stand up when you help him. He loves his bouncer that he was in earlier. He can roll over from his belly to his back and his back to his belly. He's trying to sit up from being on his back. He's almost crawling. He's got all the movements down. He's just got to put them all together, which is the thing that he's struggling with. He has found his feet. He loves playing with his feet. His sleeping schedule is a little bit off right now. As you probably can tell, it's almost 1 in the morning here and he's awake. Nothing I can do. I've been trying to get him to sleep for a couple of hours now. Isn't that right? Here, have your blankie. It's underneath me. What else could I tell you about Grayson? He loves playing with toys. He loves watching movies like Moana. He's just overall been a good baby. He's all healthy. He's up to date on his shots. He eats baby food now. He eats a 6 ounce bottle and a thing of baby food every time that he eats. In the mornings and right before bedtime, he eats oatmeal, which we make a 6 ounce bottle, pour 2 ounces of it into the bowl to make oatmeal, and he has the rest. And he is all good for a couple of hours or all night usually. So that is good, and I think that's pretty much it to cover Grayson for this update. So now I'm going to, where'd your binky go? Houdini, oh, he had it in his hand somehow and he threw it across the floor. Well, you're gonna have to wait to get that back because I ain't getting up to get it at the moment. He's looking at the floor wondering where it is. Oh, looks like I'm gonna have to get it. So for me, postpartum 5 months, everything was going pretty well for the like whole few months of me being postpartum, but these last couple, this month has just been really difficult. I've been dealing with postpartum depression, anxiety really badly, and I've been having weird UTIs. If you don't know what a UTI is, UTIs are urinary tract infections, and the main reason that I get these so often is from the catheter that I had put into me when I did have the epidural, because when you get an epidural, you are legit numb from the waist down, can't feel nothing. Well, sort of. But yeah, Yeah, but ever since I've had the catheter, I've had very many UTIs, and I've probably had about 4 UTIs for the last 5 months, which is quite a lot. Really concerning, but taking medicine for it, keeping up with that, so that is good on that part. I have also been experiencing severe back pain lately, and it's not just like little aches and pains like you would normally get for back aches. It is like super, super severe. I can't carry Grayson in his car seat very often. Like, I have my mom carry him out to the car and stuff. I can't hold Grayson for too long standing up. I can barely wash dishes because it hurts so bad to stand up for that long of a time. Just little things really hurt my back. Like, they really do. And I definitely know that it's not from the epidural in my back because it's not up where they did it. It's in my lower back, which is not where they put my epidural. They put my epidural towards the upper part of my back. So I know it's not that, but I have a doctor's appointment for my birth control on Tuesday, which I'm going to talk to them about my back, hopefully, depending on what my doctor is. If not, then I'll probably just look for a chiropractor to go through and get in contact with them and figure out what they think I should do. But yeah, overall everything else is going pretty well. My body is perfectly fine. I've been sick quite a bit lately too, which is probably from me not getting very much sleep, since he does not like to sleep, as you can tell. It does wear on me, because when I did get sick this month, I couldn't like lay down and just get better by getting sleep. So my sickness has like drastically gone on and on and on because I haven't gotten very good sleep. But I'm hoping tonight that it goes good, because I am sleeping in the living room with him in a rocky chair, as you can see, which he is clearly liking because he is really relaxed right now. So, fingers crossed that everything goes good tonight. But other than that, I think we have covered everything. So, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. And we will see you guys all in the next video. Bye, guys. Wait for them to ask you who you know.